In 2018, in what has become known as
Carrot Gate,
a UK GCSE biology question asked why carrots don't decrease in mass when boiled. Students complained,
"But we haven't been prepared for this."
Examiners said,
"We hoped you'd connect the question to something you were taught about potatoes expanding in water."
Students mistakenly thought the experiment was about carrots, not osmosis.
"Osmosis? What's that? Is it a rock band from the 1970s?
I shall explain. Living cells are contained within either animal membranes or thicker plant cell walls. These walls are only partial barriers. They block some molecules, but not all. For example, solvents, liquids that things dissolve in, like water, can pass freely in either direction. Osmosis is the process by which there is an overall motion of solvents, like water, from places of high solvent concentration to places of lower solvent concentration. So, if you put a cell in tap water, it might expand when more water enters the cell than leaves it. For years, students have watched bits of potato in water increasing in size due to osmosis. Although some didn't realise the exam question was about osmosis because it mentioned carrots, and they associated osmosis with potatoes. So let's get this straight. Osmosis can happen with all cells, animal and vegetable. Your mission is to investigate osmosis in as many different plant cells as possible. We're using a splendid variety of fruit and vegetables. Although they don't have cells, the demo works really well with gummy bears too. But we haven't got any. We shall test our samples in two liquids, tap water and salty water. Put 200 millilitres of water into each bowl. Add 10 grams of salt, that's about 2 level teaspoons, into one bowl. You can label the bowls, although taste will probably identify which is which. Peel the vegetables. Cut each into pieces of 1 centimetre square cross-section and as long as possible. Cut the ends squarely. Knives. Ugh, I hate knives. Get a grown-up to do the cutting. I got my mum. Assemble pieces in 2 rows, identical in length and number, so both sets have exactly the same surface area. It helps to make the length an exact number of centimetres. Record the total row length. Put 1 set of pieces in each bowl. Pieces of different vegetables can be in the same bowl as long as they're easy to identify and none are touching. We found most of the changes happen in just 90 minutes. So, after 90 minutes, remove the pieces, 1 set at a time. Reassemble into a row and record the new length. Work out changes in length as percentages by subtracting the start length from the final length. Divide that answer by the start length, and then multiply by 100% to get your percentage change. Share your results with us using the form on our webpage. Did the rows of vegetable change length? If they did, it'll be because water flowed either into or out of the food. It was worth the effort using several bits of each sample to give a longer total length, as it was easier to measure the small percentage change accurately. Real-world applications? Plants draw in water through roots using osmosis, and water content in vegetables indicates healthiness and ripeness. NPL scientist Richard Dudley uses invisible light called terahertz radiation to investigate cauliflower ripeness by water content, saving millions of pounds otherwise wasted by harvesting too early or too late. P.S. Osmosis was a South African rock band who got to number 2 in 1974 in the Australian music charts with their hit She Didn't Remember My Name. But at least now you will remember osmosis. I mean the effect, not the band.